Let's get into a little horror sequel from the 80s. Let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to my channel. Hope everyone's doing well out there. And I am back from vacation, as I stayed in my Halloween 2 review. My wife and my son and I went down to Universal Studios, Florida for a week. We got back last Saturday. And I'm back out with some more horror reviews because tomorrow's October 1st, people. Can't wait. My favorite time of the year. Now, this is a film I wasn't planning on reviewing, honestly. The other night, I was going through HBO Max, and this movie popped up, and I honestly haven't thought about or have seen this movie in probably these 20, 25 years, probably was the last time I saw this film. And I'm going to do the sequel because the original film to this series, there's four films, I believe, I don't know, after this film, Empire Pictures, Charles Band sold it off to Vestron Pictures because they needed money to try to save Empire. They ended up going bankrupt anyway, and then later on, Charles Band made Full Moon Pictures, that the Puppet Master series and other subspecies, all those movies came from. But this is in the 80s. There was already a Ghoulies film that came out in 84, but we're going to talk about Ghoulies 2, because this is the only film I really like in this series. I know it seems odd, but I'm going to review it. It's one I didn't plan on reviewing, but we're going to talk about it, because this is a film I used to watch. I only ever saw it on TV. When I was a kid, growing up in this little town, Tamaqua, Pennsylvania, there was a station in New York called WPIX 11 out of New York, and every October they would show a horror movie every night of the week for between 8 and 10. This is one of the films that was on heavy rotation each year. It's the only way I ever saw this film. I never rented it from the video store, but I always had a soft spot for this film, and we're going to talk about it. This film came out in 1987. This is the only sequel in the Ghoulies franchise, as you could call it, that actually got a theatrical release, although Apple had a small one. It was originally rated R, but they cut it down on PG-13 for home video, and it's only an hour and 29 minutes long. This film was directed by Charles Band's father, Albert Band, and Charles Band executive produced this film. Now, in this film, we have Royal Dano as Uncle Ned, this alcoholic. They work for this carnival, and this traveling carnival, and their attraction in this carnival is Satan's Den, this haunted house that they set up these little towns. Damon Martin plays Larry, this Uncle Ned's nephew, and he is with Uncle Ned. Uncle Ned used to be a magician, a really good one back in the day, and Larry wants to learn how to be a good magician from Uncle Ned. Unfortunately, Uncle Ned's more worried about drinking than doing magic anymore. And also in this film, you'll notice, especially if you love the Halloween series, Sasha Jensen shows up as this punk kid, and he was in Halloween 4 the next year after this film was released. And William Butler is also in this film, and William Butler's been in plenty of horror films, including Night of the Living Dead 1990, Friday the 13th Part 7 and New Blood, Texas Chainsaw Massacre 3, on and on. Royal Dano was in a ton of films over his career, The Dark Half, Outlaw Josie Wales, a lot of credits to him. And this film's very simple setup. In the beginning of the film, we see this religious guy trying to vanquish these demons in the back of this gas station. It makes no effing sense, but that's what's going on. And he's going to put him in this like acid bath. Well, the demons kill him, and Uncle Ned and Larry have problems with their semi-truck that they're driving to the next town, so they stop at this gas station, and these demons happen to sneak into the back of their truck. They make it to their next destination. They set up Satan's Den, and they're ready for the next night. But somebody from corporate headquarters, the owner's son, shows up and tells them the attractions that aren't making a lot of money, if they don't do well over this weekend where this film takes place, they're going to have to be let go. And that is pretty much the crux of the story mainly. And then obviously these demons set up shop inside this haunted attraction. And the haunted attraction has been losing a little bit of money. But on this night, these kids talk it up when they go through because they run into the demons. They think they're really super cool. And all of a sudden, the line is very long trying to get into this haunted house. And along the way, the demons start killing people. And it's not overly gory. Again, they cut it down to PG-13 for home video. They show the demons attacking people. There's some, a little bit of blood here and there, but it's not overly gory. And pretty much once they figure out Uncle Ned gets killed by the demons, and then Larry and these people at this carnival have to figure out how to kill him, which eventually they do. And then at the end, one is left over for a cliffhanger ending. Now, this film is a lot like Gremlins, only with demons. They even try to make the Ghoulies kind of cute, and they even laugh. At one point, the laugh sounds like a gremlin, honestly. It sounds like the exact same sound effect for a ghoulie laugh as it is from the gremlins. It's pretty much was their version of the gremlins, only with more of a horror bent. Is this film a great film? No. I always appreciated the carnival setting and the haunted house attraction as the main area where this takes place at. So I've always had a soft spot for this. And again, this is the first time I've seen this film in 20, 25 years. The effects on the ghoulies themselves are pretty well done when they're in one spot. When they move and they're I don't know if they're claymation or stop motion. I don't know what they did to pull off that effect, but it doesn't look good. It doesn't hold up at all. But the puppets themselves, when they're closed off, just one area and they show them, they look pretty good. Now at the end, this large demon shows up and starts eating the ghoulies. That, you can tell, was a suit. It doesn't look very convincing when it does show up. It's only in the movie for maybe 5 to 7 minutes towards the end of the film, at the very end of the film. But overall, I like the setting of it. I like this haunted attraction aspect of it. Some of the acting's pretty good. Royal Dano's good as drunk Uncle Ned. Damon Martin's good as Larry. I think he gives a pretty good performance. There's some other good performances. There's a little person with them on their crew, and he was in Bordello of Blood and many, many other films. He's really good too. The extras in this film, they filmed this in Rome, Italy, actually. So none of the extras really know how to speak English, and you'll notice during the film, no extras really talk. It's only the actors that are on screen. You don't hear anybody in the background saying anything because nobody knew how to speak English. This film, at the nighttime scenes at the carnival now, were all filmed interior soundstage in Rome, I guess so they can control the weather and they can control, everything going on at night, so they don't have to worry about rain or anything like that, wind. It was a more controlled environment. Like I said, even though Charles Band sold the rights to his series after this to Vestron, they still went bankrupt a couple years later. Anyway, Empire movies, and then he started up Full Moon Pictures later on, which had a long string of movies behind it, horror and other kinds of films. Overall, this isn't a great film, but it's a film you can sit down and have a good enough time with. It's definitely a B picture, which there's nothing wrong with. There's some funny moments. The ghoulies are kind of cool. The acting's not bad at all, considering the low budget nature of this film. I would give this film a 6 out of 10. I thought it still held up from what I remember as a kid. I still had a good enough time watching it. It's not going to win any awards, obviously, but still an enjoyable little horror film. If you have HBO Max, the original Ghoulies, and this one's on there. I don't have no intentions of going back and watching the original. I just wanted to watch this one because I have nostalgia from when I was a kid. And I still had a good enough time watching it again all these years later. Like I said, it's been 25 years probably since I've seen this film. So yeah, 6 out of 10 for Ghoulies 2. Have you ever seen this film? Leave a comment down below. Let me know. Hit the thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button. Share this video. You would appreciate that. I'll be back later on this weekend with a video of my outdoor Halloween decorations. We finally finished up. Tomorrow night, everything will be out and operational. So look out for that video on Saturday. I'll be back next week with a review for Halloween 3, Season of the Witch, and many other reviews. I'm going to do Halloween 1, John Carpenter's original Halloween, Halloween 2018, getting ready for Halloween Kills. I'm going to do Creepshow 2 this year, and many other films through the month of October. So until then, bye.